Up next on the scene at 6, a mistrial is declared in the case of a Kentucky man accused of child sexual abuse, and both state and federal officials release preliminary results in the probe into last week's natural gas explosion.
State inspectors blame the accidental death of a patient at Williamson County Hospital on human error. And in the final part of Mending Shattered Minds, we'll see how brain chemistry relates to criminal violence.
These stories and more news coming up next on the scene at 6. WSMV, Nashville. From Channel 4 News, this is The Scene at 6 with Dan Miller, Demetria Kalodimos, Bill Hall, and Charlie McAlexander.
Good evening. For the second time, a mistrial was declared in the case against Charles Raymer. This time it was a hung jury after 3 days of testimony. Raymer is charged with sexual abuse involving two children who were enrolled in a daycare center run by his wife. Al Tompkins reports from Hopkinsville.
Al Tompkins, Channel 4 News, Hopkinsville, Kentucky.
Federal and state investigators in Kentucky today released their preliminary findings into last weekend's natural gas explosion that killed five people in Metcalfe County. The initial blame has been placed on a faulty pipeline, but state officials say outside sources may have contributed to the blast. Bob Jacobs has a report.
Some health economists believe that cost containment measures are going to spell an end to high physician incomes, and that in turn is expected to affect the number of applicants applying to the nation's medical schools, like Vanderbilt.
Charlie said he didn't like it. Thank you, Bill. We will unleash Charlie Mack as the scene of 6 continues after this. Sports time. Charlie Mack's here. A few nights ago, I don't know what night it was.
I think it was Monday night.
You ran a piece with a Dan Fogelberg song.
Run for the Roses.
And Shots of Horses. It was absolutely beautiful. And we got a lot of calls on that.
A lot of calls, a lot of letters. So in the second segment, we're going to run it again.
All right. Set up your Betamax. Coming up later.
Get it ready. Tape it. Betting on horse races is a matter of statistics, and when it comes to the Kentucky Derby, stats show that being the favorite may be the kiss of death. Major League Baseball this afternoon in the National League. San Diego beat the Cubbies 6-5. Greg Nettles and Gary Templeton hit eighth-inning homers for the Padres. And in the fifth inning, Montreal leading the Atlanta Braves 4-0. Well, the Sixers have things very much their way entering tonight's NBA playoff game against the Bucks in Philly.
Consumer reporter Karla Winfrey is here with some tips for the road travelers.
Have you ever driven a far distance on a vacation?
Oh, many, and they seem much further than they were, as a matter of fact.
What's the farthest? The farthest?
I've driven to Florida. I've driven to New York. That's about it.
All by yourself?
Well, we're not going to get into exactly who went with me, but I've driven there.
Okay. And Dan, when you're planning a road trip, you should also, of course, have your car checked out. But the mistake that people make, they wait until the last minute, maybe 2 days before they're ready to go to have the car checked out, when it would be wise to have it checked out 2 weeks before, just in case they find something wrong and that won't delay your plans, and then 2 days before.
I've done that. I've actually not even had the car checked, and I've regretted that as I started the trip, too. I have traveled with kids in the car, which is not always a real pleasure as far as traveling.
Well, there are some things you can do, some tips, and I know about these because I have four younger brothers. Mm-hmm. Now, my dad used to take those Purity orange juice jugs and freeze water in them and make a big ice thing in the middle of them. And if you take those along and put them in a plastic bag, so when they start melting and everything, it won't just melt everywhere. But you can use those for water, and you won't have to stop for water or anything like that.
I was wondering where you were going with that. Okay.
Also, take along an air mattress, especially if you have a small station wagon or station wagon, because the child can just lay out on that and rest instead of being all scrunched up like this and have a crick in its neck and everything. And bring along a blanket, because sometimes children do get cool while on the air conditioning, and sometimes mom does too.
Also, it helps to rent a big trailer and put the kids back in the trailer. Well, you don't have to deal with it.
And never remember when you stop like at truck stops. Well, you don't stop at truck stops, but truck stops, road stops, or whatever. Don't forget the children.
Don't drive off and leave them there. Got you. Thank you, Carl. Dimitri?
The Metro School Board has released its area high school scores on this year's state proficiency test, and the news is very good.
With this week's Channel 4 Music Scene, I'm Charlie Chase.
And that's sports. We've got more news in just a minute.
These stories headline tonight, Scene at 6. A mistrial was declared today in the child sexual abuse trial of a Hopkinsville, Kentucky man. Charles Raymer was accused of sexually abusing two children at a daycare center that his wife runs. And both state and federal officials in Kentucky today released preliminary findings in their probe of last week's natural gas explosion near Beaumont, Kentucky. Though no details have been released, authorities placed the primary blame for the blast on faulty and corroding pipelines.
Tonight on the Scene at 10, the Senate cuts Medicaid and Medicare, but not its own salaries. President Reagan runs into opposition at the economic summit. We'll meet the latest centerfold star, and we'll have this story.
One more check on the weather before Bill gets out of here.
All right, another look at our five-day forecast. Downloads, we said an improvement. It looks pretty good, especially for the weekend with everything going on, rodeos, horse shows, Kentucky Derby. Tomorrow, look for sunny day. Low in the morning, 47, high 78. Sunday, sunny day, 52 and 80. And as of now, Monday through Wednesday of next week, partly cloudy with a real warming trend. Morning lows will be reaching for the mid-60s by the middle of the week. And afternoon highs will be in the lower 80s.
I guess you'll be going to the Kentucky Derby, right?
No, I'll be going to the backyard.
Thank you, Bill. Yeah. Thank you for watching. That's the Scene at 6. Join us later for the Scene at 10.